we were playing football, and then a couple of Georgians were coming, and they were sort of shouting at us. I don't know why, but I can speak Georgian as well, so it was aggregated as well at that time. I understand it was my fault as well, because I shouldn't have behaved that way. When I reacted, then I sort of shouted at him. He came onto me, and he pulled out his gun. He kept it on my head, and then my friends had to come and intervene. So yeah, me va tar ka dunuela Sri Lanka danwal chemi me gobre misa kian tharashi akukwe batseli ak skhorov stiblishi 2007 shamovida da tbilisi sakalsepo samadi sununs saulobda 2016 damtarda ukla ak sakatulishi mushobs.
With regards to Georgia, it's a country that first of all I really like, and that's probably the reason as to why I'm here as well. I really like the way how the traditions are, the people and the culture that they have, and also the history that they have shared with the world. It's been really good. I mean, I've always had people who've been able to reach out and help. I was in Batumi a couple of days back, and I was actually again late for the train. We went on a tour, and this guy, he did the entire tour, and he didn't charge me anything for all this trouble he took to he took my luggage and he ran to the to the train to to stop the train. So I've made a lot of Georgian friends. I have a lot of friends here, and I'm pretty much very happy here. But of course, I've heard and I've seen and I've experienced as well every now and then little bit of trouble here and there. But from my experience, I used to for example, I used to live in London before I came here. It's something that exists all over the world. I think it's to do with a certain group of people and their mentality. Most of the Georgians who have these issues, they do not have the capacity or the financial background to travel abroad and interact with other societies. But for those of them who do, they definitely know how well they need to behave around with foreigners and what foreigners are. I was the vice president for the self-government of Tbilisi State Medical University, and from that I had the opportunity to work with a lot of international students. And what I've heard is that most of the students, they have difficulties obtaining resident permits, especially for some students from different specific ethnicities, for example, let's put it that way. And the reason for denial most of the time is that they say this person is a threat to the country. So when they say that you're a threat to the country, the government needs to understand that they're making a very bold statement there. You are actually making a statement against that person's past, that person's future, and whatever that person makes. And if the government of Georgia can make such accreditations, or if they can point fingers at an individual saying that this person is a threat to the country without having a proper investigation or without having concrete evidence, that means it's very wrong, it's unbiased. I've heard that there's a far right movement who tries to oppress the rights of foreigners. I do understand that you need to stick up for your rights, for your history, for your culture. I value that, I respect that, because it's your country at the end of the day. And of course, it's the only place you have to live, and there's no other place you will ever have. I love my country and I also respect your country, but it doesn't mean that the far-right activities has the right to go and, let's say, for example, I've heard that there's a group of people who wear these camouflage costumes, and they try to put foreigners under civilian arrest, asking for their IDs, to ask them as to what rights they have to live in Georgia. I believe no one has that right, because everyone has the freedom of movement. If you don't have the freedom of movement, then Georgia cannot boom the tourism industry. As of now, Georgia is booming in tourism and there are a lot of tourists. But situations like this, and if the government does not take actions against this, it's going to tarnish the reputation of Georgia internationally, worldwide. The thing is this, something that I always believe in, I will put it this way. You see, most of the people in the world, right, they wish for something called peace, right? To be peaceful, there shouldn't be wars. But if you actually look at our human history, there's never been a period without war. The only thing that we should wish for is to be able to coexist. If we can understand about coexisting, then I think this country, this entire world will be different. people need to learn how they need to respect each other's ideas. And sometimes the ideas may not match, but it doesn't matter, because every person is entitled to have his own opinion. But as long as they don't put it on someone else, it should be fine.